Hello YouTubers. Well, since you last saw me, I was in a warm, sunny south of Texas, and I've since moved to the frozen, barren wastelands of Connecticut. So I'm going to show you here. It's been snowing on and off all month, and now they say there's going to be falling ice from the sky, falling ice. Hey, y'all, John Kenny, that ice be not that ice that you put in your margarita, boy. That ice be on the ground. They are speaking some Louisiana for an old friend of mine. Special shout out to Bob and Christine. Happy Valentine's Day on your wedding day. So I'm going to now show you my hookup of a generator. So let's take a little bit of a closer look. So we start our journey in the basement. Right behind me are all my DB boards. And in the middle here is a little box which brings our generator online. Right now we're on the grid. We switch it off, we push it down, and the generator is ready to start up. So there she is, a Westinghouse 6000 watt generator. I bought this bad boy from the previous owners of the house. It came without oil, so I had to put oil in it. It came without gasoline, so I had to put gasoline in it. Took one full can, and that's where we were. Then, if you come around the side here, I already have it open. I have the fuel line is open once you've gassed up. I've already run it for a bit. That's choke on, that's choke off. Engine's warm, doesn't need choke. And make sure there's no leaks. A little bit of gasoline came out of here in the beginning, but it seemed to stop. I think that was just the choke putting too much gas through. And then of course we read the manual. Everything's in the manual, so read it. To start her up, there's a start switch. The main breaker is off. The power cord, they didn't leave me a power cord, about 50 bucks in Amazon, got me power to the house. That's that little box that you see in the basement. Now the moment of truth. Let's start her up. Power is off. Power is off. And that is how I hooked up my generator to my house. You all have a happy Valentine's Day.